Welcome to the Gospel Light Minute. This is Daniela Whyte, and we are glad that you have tuned in. Today, Daniel Whyte III is going to share with you from a fresh and unique perspective how you can get to know Jesus Christ for yourself. Daniel Whyte III is the national best-selling author of 15 books, including Just Jesus and the Prayer Motivator. He has spoken in meetings across the United States and in 23 foreign countries. He is the president of Gospel Light Society and Torch Ministries International. Now, here's your host, Daniel Whyte III.
What the trouble in Israel, Iran, and Syria means to you. This is the chief of sinners, Daniel Whyte III, president of Gospel Light Society, reminding you that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners like you and me. Ladies and gentlemen, the current turmoil in the nations of the Middle East is not the first time all eyes have been riveted on that part of the world. And it won't be the last time either. Israel is on the brink of war with Iran as Iran attempts to build nuclear capabilities against the will of many other nations, including the United States of America. Protests and violence continue to ravage the nation of Syria and other Middle Eastern countries. History itself began in the Middle East. The traditional site of the Garden of Eden is near present-day Babylon in Iraq. And that, of course, is where the Bible says God created Adam and Eve, and where human history began. The most important event in the history, or rather in history, occurred in that part of the world, in Jerusalem, now in the nation of Israel. That's where the Lord Jesus Christ died for the sins of the world. No other event will ever be more significant than that one. When will all this turmoil end? Is there anyone who can bring order and peace out of chaos and crisis? I want you to notice today history's final showdown according to the Bible. History's final showdown will take place in the Middle East, where Israel, Syria, and Iran are. The great war of Armageddon will be fought at the end of this age. Armageddon is actually a lush valley in the northern part of Israel, southeast of Haifa. The plain, about 20 miles long and 14 miles wide, will be the scene of the future battle between the kings from the east and the nations united under Antichrist. In the book of Revelation, chapter 16, verses 13 through 16, states, "And I saw three unclean spirits, like frogs, come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirits of devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world, to gather them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watcheth and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked, and they see his shame. And he gathered them together into a place called in the Hebrew tongue Armageddon." Secondly, I want you to know who will win this battle. The battle of Armageddon will not be won by either side, but instead the Lord Jesus Christ will end it by his return from heaven with his armies. Then he, the conqueror, according to Zechariah 14:4, will stand on the Mount of Olives, which is in front of Jerusalem on the east. The victory of Jesus Christ will bring peace and tranquility on the earth, and he will rule the nations. Thirdly, why is the world's attention focused on the Middle East, on Israel, Syria, Iran, and other countries? Ladies and gentlemen, the world is very interdependent now, especially economically. Oil has taught us that. Why does the TV news report the price of oil every night, the price of gas every night? It is the oil under the Arabian sand that concerns nations worldwide and sometimes shapes their foreign policies. The need for food is also a sober reminder of the economic interdependence of the countries of the world, especially when crops are poor and famine is widespread. Why is all this significant? Because one day the Antichrist will require people to receive his mark to be able to buy or sell. The book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 17 states, "And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name." Not only will the availability of goods be interlocked between nations, but the ability to purchase or sell them will be controlled by the Antichrist. The Bible tells us what's going to happen to this world, but it is much more important to know what's going to happen to you in light of what is happening in Israel, Syria, and Iran, and the world right now. When Jesus Christ died and rose from the grave centuries ago, he paid the penalty for our sins. And now he freely offers forgiveness, heaven, and eternal life to everyone who believes in him. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here today to share this with you because time is running out. The time between now and the climax of the age of Armageddon is shorter with every passing day. We should live mindful of not only the brevity of life, but also the certainty of the Lord Jesus Christ coming back. Our knowledge of the future ought to affect our lives now. What about your future? You need to be very concerned about your destiny. If the close of the age is soon, and if you survive until the end without trusting Christ as your Savior, not only will you have to endure Armageddon, but worse, you will live forever in the torment of the lake of fire. Notice with me what the Bible says in the book of Revelation, chapter 20, verse 11. "And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no room, or rather no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged, every man according to their works, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Ladies and gentlemen, what is your response to that? Will you place your trust in Jesus Christ today, in light of what I just read to you, and receive Jesus Christ into your heart as your Savior? The Bible says in Acts chapter 16, verse 31, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved." The Bible states in the book of Romans 10:9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. And in verse 13 of chapter 10, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." Dear friend, do you believe right now in the Lord Jesus Christ? Are you trusting him? Are you willing to trust him as your Savior? Are you willing to put your faith and belief in him? Are you willing to receive him into your heart right now? If you are, if you're willing to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation, please pray with me the following simple prayer. Heavenly Father, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad and evil things in my life. I have broken your Ten Commandments. I have broken your laws. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of my sins and my unrighteousness and my iniquity. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died for me, was buried and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today. Lord, I thank you for your grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and for his sake, amen. Dear friend, if you just prayed that prayer with me, I want to be the first to congratulate you on doing the most important thing in life, and that is receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I did it over 30 years ago, and I have never regretted it, and I guarantee you that you will never regret it either. Remember, dear friend, believe by faith, share the faith, and keep the faith. May God bless you.
Thank you for listening to this Gospel Light Minute broadcast. If you would like for us to pray for you, please send your prayer request to gls@gospellightsociety.com. If you have questions about salvation, what to do after salvation, are looking for a good church home, or would like to receive a copy of our pamphlet, What to Do After You Enter Through the Door, please visit gospellightsociety.com for more information. This radio broadcast can be heard daily on bcnnradio7.com, buzzsprout.com, iTunes, Blog Talk Radio, and Live 365. Tell your friends and family to tune in and discover God's amazing grace and love. Now here's a song that will encourage you in your newfound faith in Jesus Christ. God bless.
True, you are true, even in my wandering, you are. lost its sting. And oh, I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world forever. Sing no other name, Jesus.